Welcome back to the kitchen. There is one inescapable truth. Whether you are a super endurance athlete or just a guy who loves food so much that you've made it your life, you are what you eat. And I've been loving being educated on the best way to balance my meals according to the lifestyle. Gentlemen, very good morning to you. Welcome to our little kitchen. We have, of course, Guy Clark, who is no stranger to the kitchen. He is going to be giving us a little bit of a masterclass this morning, and super endurance athlete, James Reed. Welcome. I know it is a very important time for you at the moment. You are building towards world championships. First of all, how are you feeling, man?
Great. I mean, it's been the 2 weeks leading up to a world championship event is always the most stressful because you're running a borderline between training and fatigue, and you're sort of walking along a narrow cliff. So it's a stressful time, but nevertheless, essential time.
We got you, man. We'll keep you on the right side of that cliff. I'm loving the look of what we've got out here. This is a guy's meal through and through. What are we making here?
Basically, it's very lean fish, tuna, which I'm going to sear. Awesome, like healthy way of cooking it. I'm going to serve it with a rooibos infused beetroot, and I'm going to sprinkle with some like uncooked fresh yellow pepper, which is awesome. And then I've got in the oven going some sweet potato medallions.
Oh, sounds fantastic.
High protein, low fat.
I'm very keen to see the end result here. James, where are you in your diet at the moment? I would imagine for you, for an endurance athlete, supplementation can only take you some of the way. You've got to look after your nutrition 100% of the time.
No, definitely. I mean, I think looking after nutrition is a key towards peak performance, and it's something a lot of guys can actually use to incorporate and better your performance. A diet is something that you really want to keep on top of to give your body the best possible fighting chance and the best possible recovery between sessions.
Now, when you say you're on that borderline now between sort of training fatigue and looking after your body, it must be a very difficult balance to find. How much does it differ when you're training and now building towards a big event?
Well, I mean, I think in training and when you're on a less focused time, you want to optimize your engine and expand the capacity of your engine. When you're at a critical building phase or critical racing phase, you really want to run your engine out, and you want to generally err on the side of more rather than less and always fueled up, as opposed to trying to almost optimize your engine's capacity. So it's definitely a time where you want to be focusing on the essentials, and you want to be getting enough of the essentials, and you want to be concentrating on resting and recovery.
Recovery, I hear that word all the time. Now, in your time on MasterChef, you of course had to come up against some pretty mean chefs in the kitchen. It's one thing cooking for fun, it's another thing cooking when it's a competition, man. What was that experience like?
It was pretty intense, yeah. It's like, you're not cooking for pleasure, it's actually, there's a lot on the line. Yeah.
Sounds wrong, man.
No.
what do you traditionally yourself like to cook in the kitchen?
I've always been like sort of like a cross kitchen, which is actually fusion food.
Yeah.
I love Asian cooking. It's very healthy. It's very sort of like tasty. That's kind of the route I go. I like experiments, eh? I love everything.
You've got to keep trying till you find what works for you, man. Okay, so what is the watchword when searing our tuna or cooking our tuna? How do we have to go about it?
What I find is the best route is you sear all the edges first. That way it just keeps all the flavor inside and all the moisture. It keeps it like very sort of nice. And don't do it for too long, man. This is done.
What's next in the face?
Before you got this going, you should have got the beetroot going, which is basically like 2 medium beetroots.
Mm-hmm.
You just like peel it and cut it down. 4 rooibos tea bags, pop it in there, pop it into that, in a bain-marie in the oven, cook it until it's soft, take it out, reduce that sauce down with a bit of balsamic vinegar, and it's awesome. Healthy, tasty, brilliant.
Couldn't be simpler. This is another one of those that makes you look like you're really good in the kitchen,
it
man. Now, on race day, I would imagine when the cramps kick in, dudes, there could be nothing worse. You really are at the mercy of your body. Let's talk about your supplementation. Let's talk about phosphates. How do you prevent the cramping? How do you get around that?
I think when you go to the upper limits of your exertion, you've got to really watch out for deficiencies in salt and minerals leading up into the event. So I believe in a product called phosphate loading, and in a product called Cramp Block from USN. It's a great way to almost err on the side of caution going into an event to keep your salt levels topped up. Everybody has different sweat content rates at which they sweat out salt, and that's quite an interesting field to explore. And it's nice to go into an event knowing that you're on the side of topped up, your engine is ready to run out. And when you do get into those upper limits of exertion, you can on the bike, take goos and gels to really keep your electrolytes quite high and prevent the cramping.
Now, of course, we don't all have the advantage of having a guy in our kitchen. And how do you keep the protein coming in, man? Because you're obviously running physically. That lean muscle mass is pretty much at an optimum. How do you make sure that the muscle isn't breaking down every time you step off the bike?
Definitely. I mean, I think protein is something you use, you've got to really focus on in every meal. If it's not eggs, you're going for a protein powder in your oats. Lunch is always a sort of lean protein, a tuna or a chicken, and then dinner a steak or an ostrich steak or something like that. I made the mistake as a young athlete coming into the sport by focusing too much on the carbohydrates and the sugars and not enough on the quality lean proteins as opposed to the sugars.
Well, as luck would have it, we've got a perfect protein balanced meal right here. Guy, just take us through the last little finishing touches there.
Yeah, basically it's the sweet potato on the side, molten sea salt, rooibos infused beetroot, tuna.
Fresh pepper, just to give it a little bit
of
crunch.
Keep it raw. Keep it
and then our reduction. I'm going to let you, and I never do this, dude, but it's only because you are building towards a major race. You can have first dibs. Guy, thank you so much. This is an awesome meal. I look forward to having you back. James, my friend, good luck. And there you have it. Couldn't be simpler. SMS the keyword tuna to 33728 to have this meal sent directly to your phone.